Good evening everyone. On behalf of Ramakrishna Institute of Technology, Department of Mechanical Engineering, RIT MECAT Center, I welcome you all. Mr. J. Geraldjan Brito and myself, R. Prabharan, trying to present the entire lecture series on the subject ME6603 and ME8692 finite element analysis. So this is first lecture. I am going to give a few introduction about how to prepare a FEA for exam point of view. This is YouTube link and this is our RIT MECAT Center website link. So kindly get touch with us for getting more updates. So this is FEA course outcome. After completion of this course, it's expected to that the students will be able to attain the following things. First one is that, so finite element formulation. Second thing, apply finite element formulation in one dimensional problem and a two dimensional scalar vector variable problem and isoparametric formulations. So next, so this is for the our entire lecture series agenda. First I am going to start overview. Overview means I am going to give how to prepare FEA for anonymity exam point of view. So and in continuation of the video, we are going to give so 13 marks, 2 marks and part C questions, how to solve, what are the tricks there, what are the magics we can do in finite element analysis. And further videos, we are trying to make video on derivation part and theory part, and we are going to make a video for FEA software introduction such as ANSYS and Abacus. So in continuation with that, we are going to solve the problem with the previous year university question. So this is the lecture 1. I am going to give overview and unit wise discussion. So everybody know this is the first 5 units. So first one is the introduction and one dimensional problems, third unit two dimensional scalar variable problem, and the fourth unit two dimensional vector variable problem, and so isoparametric formulation. So in my point of view, I am going to short out unit as per the hardness level. I am going to give, so first students are requested to complete so unit 3 two dimensional scalar variable problem, and we can start fourth unit and we can do that fifth unit and continuation with the first unit, and we will wind up with the second unit. So as per my point of view and hardness level, so just I have short out this. So just the based on hardness level and the syllabus point of view only, I have shortcut these things. So compared to the unit 3, so compared to the unit 2, this is for the simplest unit, so we can complete within hour. Okay, so next, so the second, third, fourth, fifth unit, so matrix is the vital role. So that's why students, so remember always, so what is the 3x3? The 3x3 means it represents row and column. So whenever do for multiplication, if for example the first matrix the range 3x3, the second range 3x4, so this is the output. So we can easily predict before making the problem. So if you take, this is the first range, this is the second range, the final output definitely will come 3x4. So here it may be deleted. So final is the 3x4. This is the very very fundamental things always remember for solving problems in second, third, fourth, fifth unit in finite element analysis. So first I am going to talk about the third unit. So third unit, this is the syllabus. So we are going to cover these are the topics. So for exam point of view also, you should remember this is the basic thing. Just I have shortcut everything. So this is the two thing. First one is the so triangular element. Second one is the so rectangular element problem. Okay. So triangular element. So in exam point of view, so they will ask. So in triangular element, so in they may ask temperature, they will be give points. From the points, we can find out the temperature. This is the first types of problem. Second type, they may give temperature region. We need to find out the so points wherever the crosses the temperature region. We need to find out the x, y, z points. This is the so third unit, very very important topics. Okay, so solving two dimensional scalar variable problems, we should remember the two things. First one is that, so whether it may be the anti-clockwise direction. Second one is that geometrical rule, the two things very important for solving scalar variable problems. Anti-clockwise direction means here we have noted this is the first point, this is for the second point, and this is for the third point. So here I have noted all the points are in anti-clockwise direction. This is the rule for first key point. Second thing, geometrical rule. Geometrical rule, so whenever so solving triangular problem, so here I am going to take this one triangle. So here this is for my, I am going to take, for example, this is the first point, so this is the second point, this is the third point. Here I am going to give, this is x1, y1, this is for the x2, y2, here this is for the x3, y3. So here I am going to apply the geometrical rule for, so solving temperature region point. Here this is my temperature region. I am going to find out, so this point is the, I am going to take, so this is the, so xa and ya, this is for the xb and yb. Here I am going to apply for the geometrical rule. Geometrical rule, so here I am going to find out the xa. So xa minus, so x2 divided by, so next one is the, so x1 minus x2 is equal to our temperature ta minus t2 divided by, so t1 minus d2. This is our geometrical rule for solving the temperature region points to points. So you should remember this concept. Here this is for the isosceles triangle, so concept we need to remember. So next one is that, so I am going to solve, so second problem, that is for the rectangular element. So rectangular element also, so we need to remember. So first one is the anticlockwise direction, second one is the geometrical rule. So that's all about third unit. So third unit is the very very simplest unit, only the two thing, one is the triangular and the rectangular element. So next I am going to talk about, so fourth unit. So fourth unit is the two dimensional vector variable problems. So here we are going to talk about, so four thing, one is the CST element, so next one is the CST element with the temperature, next one is the axis symmetric problem, and the next one is the heat transfer problem. So first one is the CST element. Whenever talk about the CST element, so CST element means that is for the constant strain triangular element. So every node have a 2 degree of freedom, so definitely the matrix will come, so 6 cross 6 for one triangle, so it may become 6 cross 6. The question, the frequently the question will come the under the category of, so the we need to find out the area, second thing we need to find out the strain displacement matrix, and D stress strain relationship matrix, and K, and the next one is the sigma, and the maximum and the minimum principal stresses, and we need to find out the principal angle and the element strain. So the further videos we will discuss about the derivation and the problem. So we will definitely attain the formula. Through the derivation we will attain the formula. The formula definitely useful for solving these problems. Okay, so you should remember the 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 category. The problems only comes only the 9 category. Okay, for only one thing we need to remember, the D means stress strain relationship matrix. So stress strain relationship matrix, so two category, one is the plane stress and the next one is the plane strain condition. Depends upon the question we need to solve this problem. Okay, so second thing is the CST element with the temperature. In question, if they given temperature means we need to follow the two steps, one is the initial strain, second one is the force vector. So only one, two thing only different, initial strain and force vector. So third one is the, so axis symmetric problem. So axis symmetric problem, so the only derivation, so every concept we need to study the derivation. From the derivation only we can obtain the formula. So here the same thing, B is the strain displacement matrix, D is the stress strain relationship matrix, so K stiffness matrix, and element stresses and element strain. Here we need to remember this nine thing. So the question frequently so come through the nine category. Okay, so next one is the fourth topic, that is for the heat transfer problem. Heat transfer problem, we need to remember the three thing. One, first one is the conduction, second one is the convection, third one is the force vector. Whenever discuss about convection, so we need to remember, so whether it may be the edge convection or phase convection. So here, so depends upon the question, we want to identify, we want to substitute the formula from the formula we can easily obtain the results. So next, so I'm going to talk about the unit 5. So unit 5, isoparametric formulation. So isoparametric formulation, so here we have only two topics, very easiest topic. First one is the Gaussian quadrature, second one is the isoparametric formulation. Gaussian quadrature, so we need to remember this is the steps and this is the key point. So first we want to find out the so number of points. Okay, number of points means so n. So frequently they may in the question, so we have seen only up to 3 points. So first we should remember up to 3 points, what is the x value and what is the weight function we need to remember. So further videos we will teach, so what is that number of points, what is the weighting function. So for if number of points are 2 means what is the x value weighting function we will discuss. So we can find out the so n from this formula. So 2n minus 1 equal to polynomial order. Polynomial order means if for example this is for the 2 means 2n minus 1 equal to 2, from that we can identify the n value. So depend upon the n value we want to substitute x and weighting function. So whenever solving the Gaussian quadrature, so we need to remember this is the steps. First we want to substitute the x value, and then second step we want to multiply weighting function with that x value, that we need to add all values. This is the things we need to remember. And so whenever the trigonometry function, we want to use the radian mode. This is the steps we need to remember. So further video we will solve the problem and so derivation. Second thing, so second part for the 5th unit, that is for the isoparametric element. So isoparametric element, so frequently so question will come through the 4 thing. First one is the how to convert local coordinate into Cartesian coordinate. Second thing, how to convert Cartesian coordinate into local coordinate. This is the very important problem. So local coordinate mean epsilon eta and Cartesian coordinate mean x and y. Second thing, so that is for the Jacobian matrix. So Jacobian matrix is the so one single 12 mark or 8 mark, so definitely it may come. So this is for the second thing. The third one is the strain displacement matrix, and fourth one is the force vector. So this is the category for isoparametric element. So next I'm going to talk about the unit 1. So unit 1, so unit 2, 3, 4, 5, so depends upon the matrix. So unit 1 we are going to discuss about some mathematical point of view. So here only the 2 category. First one is the weighted residual method, so it useful for the solving problem in non-structural. Second one is the Rayleigh-Ritz method, it is used for solving problem in structural like problems. So Rayleigh-Ritz method is also called a functional approximation method. So whenever solving weighted residual method, so we need to remember the 4 thing, the 4 subcategory. First one is the point collocation, subdomain, least square and Kalergin approach. So point collocation means just we can remember the residue is equal to 0. Second thing, the integral of residue is equal to subdomain. So integral of residue square is the least square. Weighting function under residue is called a Kalergin approach. So this is the 4th thing for solving the non-structural problems. So next, so whenever solving the Rayleigh-Ritz method, so this is the points we should remember. The trial function is the so vital role. So where we can solve, first one is the polynomial function, otherwise we can use the trigonometry function. We know the trigonometry function is the very accurate. So depends upon the question, we can take that whether the polynomial trial function or trigonometry trial function. Okay, so polynomial trial function means so we can take a1 plus a2x plus a3x square plus a4x cube. So it may be goes like that. So we can take up to the square term, so a1 plus a2x plus a3x square, it's enough. So trigonometry function, so if I'm going to take the first order, a1 sine so pi x pi l, it's enough. Otherwise so it may be goes on a2 sine 3 pi x pi l, so 5 pi x pi l, it may be goes like that. So it's enough for the first order, it's enough for getting so accurate solution. So here the key point, so only one thing, so potential energy is equal to strain energy minus work done, pi equal to u minus w, you should remember. So depend upon the configuration, the strain energy and the work done value will be vary. So Rayleigh-Ritz method, so frequently question will come the category of so simply supported beam point load, or simply supported with UDL, or cantilever with UDL, or cantilever with point load, or fixed bar sum. This is for the so important problems. So further on video we will discuss about that So strain energy work done and the concept based things. Okay. So next I am going to talk about. So in first unit sometime they may ask in part C. So they may ask cost elimination method, whether it may be cost Jacobian, Gauss Jordan method. So from that we can find out the x, y, z for the so equations. Second thing, so frequently asked FEA procedure. So it may be comes 6 mark or 12 mark. FEA procedure means, so what is the pre-processing, what is the post-processing, what is the solution. So based on that software what we are following, so like that we can explain the FEA procedure in the analytical way and as well as we can use the software procedure. Okay, we will talk on that so further videos. So next, the last one is the unit 2, one dimensional problem. So unit 2 is the very vast syllabus. So we have so 10 more topics are there. That's why we took the last. So we can cover within 4 to 5 hours, we can cover so all the 10 topics. So first one is that, so bar element. So whenever I discuss about the bar element, so we need to remember these things. What is mean by force vector, what is mean by B and K, and what is the stresses, strain, and support reaction, and shape function, and strain energy. Okay, this is the thing we should remember for solving the bar element problem. Okay, so bar element, it may be categorized stepped bar. Next one is the self-weight consideration. Okay, this is the two thing we can solve the problem. Depends upon the configuration, we have to take this, whether it may be self-weight consideration. So, and if it is a stepped bar, we have to convert it into 1D element. So we want to follow some procedure we will discuss in the later on videos. So here stepped bar self weight consideration, the same thing we need to find out in the problem, that is the force vector. So first we need to find out, we need to identify the so FEA diagram, whether it is a one dimensional or two dimensional diagram. From that, so we can find out the individual element stiffness matrix. So from that we can find out the global stiffness matrix. So further on we can find out the force and support reaction. This is the points we need to remember. Second, the third thing is the temperature effect in the bar element. So temperature, the same thing we are going to follow, the same procedure, but additional, so alpha and delta values. Depends upon the alpha thermal coefficient value and the change in temperature, the formula derivation will be changes. According to the derivation and the formula, we need to solve the problem. This is for the temperature effects in bar element. So next, the heat transfer problem. Heat transfer problem very easy. So one dimensional heat transfer problem. In that third, fourth unit, we have discussed about two dimensional heat transfer problem. This is very easiest thing. So conduction and convection and force vector. So F equal to KT, this is the Fein-Tolman equation. From that we can easily solve the problems. So fifth and sixth one is the fin element problems, and one is the so quadratic bar element. So last two universities problem. So we have seen fin element problem. The fin element is the very important in the second unit. So we can fin element problem, we can solve second unit procedure as well as the first unit procedure. Depends upon the question range we want to select, whether first unit procedure or second unit procedure. Just I will show on that further videos the university question. So it may be comes the category for first unit as well as the second unit. So just don't confuse about the fin element problem. Here we are going to find out conduction, convection and force vector. So here this is for the fin element. So definitely we need to consider for the internal heat generation. This is the things we need to remember for the fin element. So next one is the quadratic bar element. So up to that, so we have discussed about 1D linear bar element. This is for the quadratic bar element. So single element we have obtained the three node. So depends upon that. So further video we will get some derivation. From the derivation we will obtain formula. So from that formula we can solve the problem. This is the same thing, the how to derive the B, G, K and F force vector. So next one is the seventh and eighth topic, spring element, and next one, eighth one is the beam element. So spring element very rare topic but very easiest thing. So the same thing, we are going to find out the element stresses, K, B and force vector values. So beam element in the second unit aspect, the last three university question, so it may come beam element or dynamic analysis or otherwise fin element. There is the three topics are very very important. In beam element we are going to obtain slope as well as deflection, very simplest thing we will discuss. So beam element we want to know about how to take the degree of freedom, that point of view we will discuss. So next one is the last topic, 9th topic and 10th topic. So dynamic analysis and stress element. So dynamic analysis is also very very important. We need to remember the two things, whether longitudinal bar element or transverse beam element. So whenever consider the mass matrix M, so whether it may be comes under the category for consistent or lumped, so consistent is the accurate one. So related to that, we will discuss on the further video. So how to obtain consistent and lumped mass analysis. The last one is the truss element. So truss element, so last 2 years back, truss element comes in the part C question, very very easiest topic. So from the truss element, we are going to obtain how to, we will discuss how to obtain the stiffness matrix and element stresses. Okay, this is the way we are going to conclude. So other topics we will discuss torsion and serendipity elements in the so last videos. So next, so the agenda, so this is for the overview unit wise discussion. So what is the first unit, second unit, third unit, fourth unit, fifth unit, which one is the convenient for starting first. So like that we have discussed. So further videos we will discuss problems, derivation theory part and previous year university question. So thank you, get in touch with us, definitely we will be get the more updates. So first subscribe so YouTube channel and get touch with our RIT MECAT center, so website link, so I will give in here description link. Just kindly subscribe and get new updates. Thank you.